Okay, so I am going to talk about interest rates because I feel like that I get that question a lot, a lot. People want to know, how do you figure the interest rates? So the point of the interest rates is not, you know what, interest rates don't really stress me out because if you're using velocity banking correctly, you really shouldn't be paying whatever interest rates you have, whether it's 5% or whether it's 15%. You're obviously going to be working that down very quickly throughout the month with your income going into your tool, whatever your tool is that you're using, whether it be a line of credit or a credit card, a PLOC, which is a personal line of credit, or a HELOC, which is a home equity line of credit. If time allows, could you show us how a $10,000 car at 2% on a loan is not as good as on a 10% HELOC? We are not doing this. Just think it might help it click with my wife. I can go over that right quick. I think that the best way to answer that is because with this amortization schedule, this 100 is part of that is going to interest, whereas let's say if you had 50% going to interest here, then you might have, which I doubt you would at your first payment, but you might have 10% going here, okay? Because as you work down the amortization schedule, more interest is paid up front than later on in the loan. So that being said, what is the difference with a $10,000 car loan and transferring that into a $10,000 car line? Well, if you make $5,000 a month, for example, and you transfer this $10,000 into a $10,000 line of credit, and your income is $5,000, your income can transfer into this $10,000 throughout the month. So it is knocking down any interest that you would pay. That's why when the interest rate is higher on a line of credit than it is on, like he said, a 2% car loan compared to a 10% line, you're not paying 10% on the line if you're doing velocity banking correctly. Like I just said, you will be cutting your interest way, way down. So if you are putting the $5,000 and then they're doing an average daily balance on this amount, that's where you're winning. That's where you'll win every time. So when your income's going in, you're satisfying this payment. So this payment that you had here has been eliminated because you have now paid this off. You've transferred the car loan into a line of credit. Then you're going to be working your income in, which depending upon your cash flow, most of these $10,000 balances are gone within 3 to 10 months. It depends on what your cash flow is. As soon as this hits it, your balance comes down. Then any expenses that you have coming out throughout the month are going to come throughout the month. They're not just going to plop in there on one day. You might pay your electric bill today. You might go get a tank of gas tomorrow. You may go to the grocery store next week. So slowly your expenses start coming back out of here. So your interest is lower because you're never paying interest on the high balance of $10,000. When you have an amortized schedule that's set up on in a loan, you're paying the interest all the way through because they figure your interest in, then they set it up in these monthly payments. So you're hitting interest every time you're making a car payment or any kind of payment. So I hope that kind of clears it up just a little bit. I don't know if that makes sense or not, but that's the way I look at it. That's the way I got rid of so many of, I've had 2 cars, 3 maybe, and have been able to pay them off very quickly because of this strategy right here. I hope that makes sense. What is the best way to increase income? Do you have a one-on-one for that as well? Increase income, I mean, that's kind of on you to figure that one out. Increasing income, I don't know if you're talking about getting another job or talking about working with a coach that helps you or talking about starting an Amazon store. I mean, there's all kinds of ways to increase the income. I'm not real sure about your question. Okay, so with your interest rate, let's talk about that because we talked about the difference in transferring an amortization schedule into a line of credit. Now, the amortization schedule, when they, like I said just a second ago, when they figure your interest over the car loan, the home loan, the home loans are a demon, wow. when they take these ridiculous amounts, such as a mortgage, they tack on the interest, they spread that over 30 years, then they front load it to the first 7 years. That's why you never, ever hardly pay off your home. That's why only 1% of Americans ever pays off their property, because it is set up for you not to pay it off, okay? And I'll get the question a lot, because in my videos, I'll show that, like, if you have a 4% interest rate on a mortgage, I'll say you have to take that times 2, which is 80, right? Then you add a 0. It's 4 times 2 is 8, and then add a 0. So it's 80% interest that you're paying. It doesn't matter if it's 6% times 2 equals 12. Add a 0, you're paying 120% interest. So the little bitty interest rate that they give you when you purchase a home is a lie from the devil. That is not what you pay. And if you go to your closing documents, okay, if you've got a mortgage recently, they made that in 2017. I think they made it a law that they had to disclose the actual interest rate on a mortgage. It's on your closing documents. I think it's like the third page, halfway down. It will literally say, this is your interest, it's going to show, this is the interest rate you were quoted. Then right under it, in big letters, and if I'm lying, I'm crazy, okay? It literally says that right under this little number they give you. This is not your actual rate. Then, in the next line down, it will say, let's say you had the 6%, they would say 120.345% is your actual volume, okay? It's crazy. When I learned that, I thought, wow, that is so dirty that they can make you think that you are getting this low baby rate when you are getting eat up with interest, and you have no idea that you're getting eat up. Another thing that they'll do with interest on mortgages, for sure, is so if they have 6% rate and you're actually paying 120%, they'll take your amortization schedule and say your payment is $1,000 a month. This payment here is probably going to have about $100 that's actually going to your home. So $900 would go to interest, and then $100 would go on your home that you bought. Then in month two, you may have $895 goes to interest, and then $105 goes to your home. And that is literally how little of a dent that you're making in your home. That's why it seems impossible to pay it off, because they take all of that 120% interest and they front load it into the very front of your loan. So if you have a 30-year loan, you're going to pay most of that 100% in the first 7 years. That's crazy to me. Every time that comes out of my mouth, I'm like, that ought to be illegal. But that's what they do. So they front load it in the first 7 years. And like, that's not bad enough. When you have been into that home loan for about 4 years, they're going to send you refi papers, right? I mean, you all could raise your hand in here for how many people have received refinance papers on your home after you're into a mortgage for just a few years. Why are they doing that? Well, the paper that they send us tells us you've been a good little girl. You've been a good little boy. You have made your payments, and now we are going to allow you to take some equity out of your home. So if you will refinance, we're going to cut your 6% rate down to 5.75%. And we're going to give you $25,000 of equity to do whatever you want to do with it. All of this is a complete lie. This is not because you've been good with making your payments. This is not because you've gained this much equity in your home. This is because when they do this, this right here goes and starts all over again. So now all of that interest you paid up to the first 4 years, that was just gravy given to them. Now you've refinanced it and you get to start this again. So you get to start paying them all of that interest all over again. It's a dirty setup, and I'm going to say that until they change it or I die, because this is very, very demonistic, these mortgages. Why do they call it a mortgage? Everybody in the room should know why they call this a mortgage. Where did that ever come from? Well, let's break it down. got your root word mort, which is, everybody knows, death, mortician, right? Death, gage. What is gage? Gage can be considered a grip or it can be considered a pledge. So either way, a death grip or a death pledge. Why would they name something like that? I mean, let's think about this for a second. Why would they give it a name of death pledge? Because it's 30 years and they know that you're basically going to be paying them a crap load of interest and then you'll die? Or you're just stuck. I mean, you're just stuck in this cycle of refinancing. Why do they put the interest on the first 7 years? Because statistically, every American family moves in the first 7 years. So guess what? It doesn't matter if you move. It doesn't matter if you refinance. In that first 7 years, they are going to hit you again. You are going to get to pay all of that interest I just showed you again. Reset, right? Reset. Everything is a reset. So it's not that they're excited to give you this big home for these little bitty payments every month. That's what they tell us. I remember that when I was younger I believe I was talking to my mom about it. And she's like, well, yeah, you're always going to be making a house payment because it's just not possible to pay one off. And I'm like, oh, okay. Well, I'm just always going to have a house payment. And it's only like, you know, at that time it was about $1,200 a month. And I'm like, oh, okay, it's $1,200 a month. I can do that. Literally, the mindset is I'm always going to be making a house payment because who could afford to pay off, you know, $200,000 in 1980, right? So change the way you're thinking about interest. When you're talking about a loan, an amortized loan, you're talking about a whole different ball game than a line of credit. Two different types of interest. Now let's talk about the simple interest. We talked about these demons, right? The amortized loan. Let's talk about the line. Why is the line favorable? So like I showed with the $10,000 car right now that he was talking about, that we're going to transfer it into a line of credit, right? So the $10,000, if you all have not seen my video, the video shows how taking a $10,000 line of credit and putting it into a mortgage, the interest savings. So it shows the difference of using just a line of credit, and I believe I had it at 12%. And then I compared it to a 4% mortgage interest, okay? So it ended up to where it was saving well over $100,000 in interest just by using a $10,000 chunk on the mortgage. And I think it was once a year. It was crazy. So when you're talking about a line of credit, though, you're talking about simple interest. This is not amortized. This is not compound. This is simple. Simple interest means that you're taking the interest rate times the average daily balance. So when I just showed you the car loan, I said that if you have a $10,000 line, you put in income, say you have $5,000 a month income, your balance being back down to $5,000, then you're going to have your expenses come back out throughout the month, and this will grow back up a little bit. When you have the $10,000 and the $5,000, say, on your high and your low, they're going to average that. So if you take $10,000 plus $5,000 and you divide it by 2, that is how you're going to get your average daily balance. So let's just do it. $10,000 plus $5,000 divided by 2 equals $7,500. So I'll write that down. Y'all just stay with me. So we're going to average $7,500. Now you take it times this 12% or whatever your interest rate is. So times 12%, that's $900. Wow, that seems like a lot of interest for 1 month on this, doesn't it? It's not. This is for the year. This is for the entire year. So then you would divide it by 365 if you want to know what you're paying per day. So let's divide it by 365. That's $2.46 a day, and then times 30 for the whole month. So that's $73.80. So your interest on this month would be $73.80. I hope that makes sense.